Okay, so in this video, I want to do something different. I want to draw something for you to explain a very simple concept, which is the basic technology of affiliate marketing. Okay, so the basic thing or the basic technology of affiliate marketing is cookies. And no, these are not the type that you eat. Okay, a cookie in the IT world is basically a very small file. Oh, it looks almost like a text file on your computer. So it's a very, very small file that is placed in a person's computer that contains very, very important information about an application or login or username or password. Now, if you've used your Gmail account before, or Yahoo Mail, or whatever, or most other applications like Facebook, for example, okay, so you notice that once you log into Facebook on your browser, and then you close the browser, or even shut down your computer and restart again, Facebook will not ask you for your username and password again, and the same goes with Gmail as well. Why? Because they use cookies. So with cookies, they actually, once you log into Facebook, they store your username information, your password information, and your last login time, etc., in the cookie. So it's all encrypted, so you don't have to worry about someone being able to read that. And only the application that created the cookie can actually retrieve information from the cookie. So Facebook, for example, will place a cookie in your computer when you log in. And then when you restart your computer, it will look for the cookie again. If the cookie exists, then Facebook will skip the login part. If the cookie has been deleted or flushed or has been expired, let's say after 48 hours, then it will ask you to log in again. Now, cookies are very dependent on the browser. So every browser has a different set of cookies. For example, if you log in to Gmail using Firefox and then you open your Safari or your Chrome, that cookie does not get carried over because Firefox has its own cookie, Chrome has their own cookie, etc. Okay, so how does cookies matter in affiliate marketing? Basically, it works the same way as your Gmail or Facebook. Okay, every time someone clicks on your affiliate link, the affiliate platform or affiliate tracking system will place a cookie in the user's computer. So let me give you an example here. Here is your user, and here is the product or service or website that you are promoting. Okay, nice picture here, and here you got add to cart. All right, so this is your vendor or your merchant, and this is your user, of course. So the user needs to buy the products in affiliate marketing. It's as simple as that. Okay, if there's nothing to sell, if there are no merchants selling anything, then affiliate marketing just will not exist, because you get paid to refer a sale, sometimes a lead. But we'll get into that later. But in most cases, most affiliate programs are pay per sale. So you get paid for referring a sale. So there must be something on sale, and there must be someone wanting to buy whatever that is being sold online. Now, how does affiliate marketing work? Alright, so of course the user can go directly to the merchant site. Okay, if they know the website, if they know exactly what they're looking for, then they can go to the affiliate site directly. But in most cases, they don't. So in most cases, they go through someone else, an influencer, a blogger, a website owner, someone who has posted something on a Twitter page, etc. So the website owner, the Facebook account owner, or Twitter owner can be you. So what happens here? Okay, if the user visits your website or visits your FB page or checks out some of your Twitter posts, and you mention a product and you send the user directly to the product, let's say an Amazon product, okay, you send him directly to the product with a direct Amazon link, you get no commissions whatsoever. So with affiliate marketing, you need something else. You need a third-party tracking system, okay, and that's where the affiliate platform comes in. So affiliate platforms are like ClickBank, JVZoo, CJ, etc. There's so many affiliate platforms over there. Now, what happens here is you start, instead of sending traffic directly to the merchant site, you will get an affiliate link for the exact same product from these affiliate networks. The merchant or the seller would have listed their products in the affiliate platforms that you see here, and the affiliate platforms will give you an affiliate link. So now you use an affiliate link, okay? So how that works is when the user visits your site, reads about a product, something launching, something new, or you blog about it, or you put it in your Facebook, you put your affiliate link in your Twitter account, and they click on it, it will actually go to the affiliate platform first. And that's where all the tracking happens. And they would record everything like the time of click, the country, lots of different information will be recorded here. Once the information has been recorded, the affiliate network would place a cookie in the user's computer. Now, this cookie will have very important information, okay? But the most important is the affiliate ID. So since the user clicked on your affiliate link, then when the cookie is placed, your affiliate ID will be in the cookie. Once they've placed the cookie on the user's computer, they will then redirect the user to the merchant site. And when they go ahead, check out the products and buy the product that they want, and they go to the checkout page for that merchant, so there will be a code given by the affiliate platforms to the merchant that they need to place on the thank you page or the checkout page of the e-commerce system. So when the users completed a payment and reaches the checkout page, then the merchant site will actually communicate back with the affiliate platform, and the affiliate platform will check for the cookie on the user's computer. And if no cookie exists, then they will ignore that transaction, because affiliate platforms only record transactions that are affiliate transactions, okay? But if the cookie does exist, then they will get back that information, okay, like this. They will get back the information, and of course your affiliate ID is in here, okay? And then they will notify you, hey, you have made an affiliate commission. So the cookie here is placed by the affiliate platform. They are the ones tracking everything, or an in-house affiliate program that has affiliate marketing features. It is not placed by the merchant itself. The merchant may place a cookie on the user, but that is for their own use. Typically, when you browse the internet, you'll have thousands of cookies in your computer. You don't always realize that it's happening, but there's definitely thousands of cookies on your computer. So the merchant, since they have an account at these affiliate networks, for example, okay, they will be able to log in and check that you have made an affiliate sale for this particular product, and then they can then verify that product. In some affiliate networks, they can cancel your commission if they feel that that sale was not legitimate, or if a refund has happened, they can cancel it. Now let's go back to cookies. Cookies have an expiration date. It really depends on the affiliate network. In most cases, it is 30 days, sometimes it's 60 days, sometimes it's 90 days, sometimes it is lifetime. So when the affiliate platform checks for the user's cookie, if no cookie exists, then they just don't record the affiliate transaction, okay? And this can happen sometimes when a user initially starts with a different browser, but then closes the browser and then goes directly to the merchant site in a different browser, okay? For example, if the user initially clicked on in using Chrome, but then later completed the transaction using Firefox or Internet Explorer, or even completed the transaction in a different computer where the cookie does not exist, then the affiliate platform will not be able to tell that you are the referring affiliate. The merchant site would not be able to pass any information back to the affiliate platform, and therefore you don't get credited for the affiliate sale. But that being said, the chances of that happening is very, very small, but there is a chance of that happening, okay, in natural internet use, as you would understand. So cookie expiration dates, sometimes you have 30 days, which is the most common, you have 60 days, you even have 90 days, and sometimes you have lifetime. So when the affiliate networks checks for the cookie, if the cookie does not exist, or if it has expired, if it has passed this expiration date, then it will just not record the transaction. Or sometimes it can record the transaction, but it will not credit you for the sale. So basically, in affiliate marketing, cookies are very, very important. They are what control affiliate marketing. They're the backbone of affiliate marketing. And it's how almost all affiliate platforms will track your affiliate commissions. Now, another way a user can simply remove cookies is by clearing the cache and cookies in their browser. So in Chrome, in Firefox, all browsers, all modern browsers have the ability for you to clear your browsing history, clear your cookies. So if they clear the cookies, they are considered no longer cookied by this affiliate platform, And if they actually make a transaction, after they have clicked on the affiliate link, then they clear the cookies and they make the transaction, okay, you don't get commissions as well. But the chances of that happening is very, very small, okay. Sometimes someone will clear the cookie, but it's very rarely that they will clear the cookie after clicking on your affiliate link and before completing the transaction, okay? Because online transactions typically take a very short time unless there's some issue or there's some problems during the transaction process here, okay? But in most cases, it happens in a very short time, a matter of minutes, sometimes at most maybe even an hour, but not longer than that. So if the user from the same computer, from the same browser, click on your affiliate link but did not buy immediately and he came back 15 days later, and if the cookie has a 30-day expiration period, so 15 days is still less than 30 days, okay? So that means the cookie is still valid. And even if they go directly to the merchant site, okay, when they complete the transaction, the merchant site will feedback the information to the affiliate platform. The affiliate platform will check for the cookie and say, yes, this cookie was placed 30 days ago, but it is still valid. Therefore, we are going to credit you, the affiliate, for the sale. And that's how you make money with affiliate marketing. Okay, so I hope my little diagram here was useful. And now let's continue with the rest of the course.